guys doing? It's Billy Ashbaugh here with drummerconnection.com, and today we're applying 16th note to fills, part 3, the end of the journey. You know the system. Basically, we've got three parts. We're understanding the rhythms first, learning how to read them, then we're going to do what we're doing today, apply them around different fill settings, and then we're going to put them on the bass drum and apply them in grooves. So obviously, before you get to this stage or the groove stage, you really have to have these patterns, these rhythms memorized. You can't be second guessing. So assuming that you do, let's get busy. All right, if you haven't already done so, please go to drummerconnection.com/drum lessons and download the PDF that's going to have a page of these rhythms, 16th note rhythms part 3. Underneath the window where you're watching this lesson, there's a download tab. Click on that and that will allow you to download this PDF. I recommend printing it and getting in front of you because we're going to, again, work out of this like it's a book. So the first concept we talked about before, which is we're going to basically start moving these patterns, these rhythms around the drum set. Part one, we started out moving one beat per drum, just kind of getting used to moving around. Part two, we just sort of played around randomly with the hands. And here in part three, I want to give you another idea where we're going to actually, we talked about the space and how important that is. We're going to slow this thing down like you're playing a ballad almost. And the space is going to really become huge, but it's a big challenge to stick to these notes, not play anymore, and just move around. Now, when I slow it down like this, I really like to play flams. It sort of opens up and gives like that power ballad kind of feel. So I'm going to give you an example of line 6. Very slow. I'll do it about 55 beats per minute. Okay, that stuff can be challenging. The slower it gets, the harder it gets. So remember, just be patient and go at your own speed. Let's move on to the next idea. We've done this before, the first two parts. We're going to the snare drum. Steady flow, 16th notes as ghost notes. Very quietly, the rhythms only now become the accents. Quarter notes, eighth notes, right hand. E's and uhs are always the left. I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to repeat the first measure of line 3, let you hear what that sounds like. In part two, we talked about a great way to sort of practice these and as an exercise before they become fills is to get the feet involved and just simply go down the page, taking your time and repeating each measure as you need or as often as you need until it feels comfortable. Another version that you could use is to simply switch to a samba kick pattern. So now instead of doing quarter notes, you're doing the first and last 16th note of every beat. So here's what line 2 sounds like with the samba kick underneath. Okay, let's take the feet out and start applying this as a one bar fill. Here's a look at line 3. Okay, just like before, now we're going to take the bass drum and follow the accents along with the rim shots. Here's the first measure of line 4. here's line four, these rhythms used in a fill setting. Okay, final idea, just like before, let's move the right hand and left hand up to the crashes, keeping the ghost notes, still with the bass drum underneath. Here's a look at the first measure for line five. And here's line five as written. Okay, that's it for today. Hope you're enjoying this. It's a lot of fun. I enjoy sharing these ideas with you guys. Remember, once you learn to memorize these rhythms, these notes, the idea is to think musically around the drum set. Today we did it with fills. In other lessons, we'll do it with grooves. So you guys check back. We'll see you soon.